Patching Granny 3 is easy when your show and everything is planned out so you can patch it in descending order. But sometimes you'll encounter a lighting rig where the fixtures are not patched in a smart order. This video is actually inspired from a question I received in the comment section from GCats5513 from Athens in Greece. And it says, great video, thank you. What if you can't patch the fixtures in groups but need to go Viper Aura, etc.? What's the fastest way to do that? So in this video, I'm going to show you three different ways you can patch your Granny 3 console. So let's get into it. In the description below, you can find a OneDrive shared folder with some files in it. And the files for this episode is episode 19. And as you can see, we have a 2D plan, we have a patch by spot, we have patch by universe 1, and we have patch by universe 2. So for the first one, we need to go into our 2D plan right here. And if we select then, you can see exactly how many fixtures you need to put into your Granny 3 console and in which mode they have to be in. So what I've done here is all my Atomics is in mode 4. All my Vipers is in the 16-bit standard mode, not the extended mode. And you can see it uses 26 channels. And the Aura XB is also in the standard mode of 14 channels. So start by putting that amount into your console. And as you can see, that is what I have done right here. So to be able to patch this, you need to go into to patch by spot, which is the first technique we're going to use. And as you can see right here, we have 301 through to 304 is on universe 1. So let's find all our Atomics, they're all down here, and we need 301 through 304. So we simply select them here and we right click and we say they need to be patched at 1.297. So we simply patch to 1.297, please. So you can see we just patched our first fixtures. Now we look for the next thing that goes into universe number 1, that is Mac Auras 601 through 610. So we find all our Auras, 601, and we go all the way down to 610 right here. We right click and we say it need to be on universe 1.157. Universe 1.157, please. And now we need to find all our Vipers. They are 701 through to 706. So we find them down here, 701 through to 706. And we right click and we patch them at 1.1. So that's basically the first universe. This is the technique we know. This is kind of slow, kind of tedious. It's a way of doing it. We just patched one universe right now and we did it the old fashioned way. So this is the normal way of patching a Granny 3 show. In a minute, I'll show you technique number 2, which is very easy to do and can be used if the fixtures are planned out in a more random order, just like the one I just showed you. But before we get into that, if you have learned something so far, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. This gives me some free support and indicates to YouTube that it should spread out to more people. And subscribe to the channel is definitely a good option so you don't miss any future episodes from this channel in the future. So let's look at patch technique number 2. I have deleted the patch we just made and now I'll show you technique number 2 to patch the Granny 3 show file. This time we go back into the shared folder. We find the file called patch by universe 1. We open it up and as you can see here, this time all the fixtures are sorted in the order of the patch. Everything is from universe 1 and it starts at 1 and goes all the way down. So what we have here is 701 through 706. So basically what we need to do is go over here again and say 701 through 706. We take them over here and we start with number 1. We go all the way down to 6 and then we just leave it like that. What else do we need now? 601 through 610. We go over here and take this small little one over here and we move all the way up into, we find unit fixture, or sorry, fixture 601. We press down and hold down control on your keyboard and then you mark 601 all the way down to 610 like this. We release and then we find the last ones, which is 301 through 304. Once again, we move this little one all the way down. Be sure not to scroll on your mouse because then it's going to forget the selection order you have right now. So 301 through 304, once again, we press down and hold control, and we select all the way down to number 4. We release, and that's it. Now we have selected everything in the right order, as you can see right now. So what we need to do now is right-click here and say, where do we want to start? We want to start at 1.1. So we patch to 1.1, please. And now we patched the entire universe with only one single little click. And as you can see here, the last atomic address is 309. And right here, it's 309. So this is basically how technique number 2 works. You simply select them in the right order, all of them, and you don't use your scroller. You simply use this one up here to go up and down. You select the one, you press control, you select, and then you right click and patch them. That is technique number 2. In a minute, I'll show you technique number 3 to patching your Granny M3 console, so be sure to stick around for that. And please leave a comment below if you have anything on your mind. I can tell you I had many discussions in the comment section with you guys already, and it's really motivating for me to know that someone is watching, and sometimes I can even help you with some Granny M3 related questions if you get stuck with something. So please let me hear from you in the comment section. And if you're looking at getting some Granny M3 hardware yourself, I have a bunch of links in the description where you can have a good look at them. You can see the different models and you can go in and study each of them so you know how they're configured and what model would be the right fit for you. The last Granny M3 patch technique I'll show you is probably the fastest if you have a patch sheet in front of you. And this is basically the way we used to do it on whole hog consoles and different other models as well. So let's get right into that. Once again, we select all our patch here. We right click and we say unpatch. And now we have everything in here. There's nothing patched, but we have all our fixtures as we did before. So this time we're simply going to close the patch. We're going to save and exit, and we are going to use the command line. So if we have the patch sheet in front of us, you can see that it's the same sheet patched by universe. We have spot number 701 through 706 and so forth. This time we're going to use the command line, and we have the command line right here in front of us. So basically we're just going to say patch fixture, and we say 701 through 706 plus 601 through 610 plus 301 through 304, and we say enter, and it's going to ask us, where do you want to patch it? We simply say patch to 1.1, please, and it exits the patch again, and we're done. So right now, if we open the patch up, you will see that everything is patched the way we wanted it on universe number 1. So this is basically the fastest way you can patch it. And it's also a little bit dangerous, so be careful in here, because if you patch something to the wrong address, it's going to warn you, but still, working in the patch gives you maybe a bit better clarity over what it is you're doing. I hope this video gives you a better understanding of the Granny M3 patch techniques, and as maybe you can see the benefit in all three different kinds of techniques. I mean, sometimes you'll use one, sometimes you'll use the other, and that's fine. If you're interested in being a better Granny M3 programmer, make sure you watch this next video, and please follow along on your Granny M3 on PC at home. Watching someone program Granny M3 is fine, but doing it yourself will help you remember when you need it in real life. I release one video every week on this channel, so be sure to subscribe and click the little bell icon. If you don't want to miss the next episode, you'll be notified when we release new content. I hope to see you on the channel again in the future, and until then, happy Granny M3 programming.